I'm Elisa McCall at Polar Bears International. I'm the Director of Conservation Outreach and a Staff Scientist.
And I'm BJ Kirchhofer, the Director of Field Operations for Polar Bears International.
And our mission at Polar Bears International is to keep polar bears in the Arctic always. We work to protect their sea ice habitat through a mix of education, research, and advocacy.
Right now we're sitting on Tundra Buggy 1, and this is our mobile broadcast studio. From here we're able to take a live stream of scientists and other educators and blast them out to schools all over the world through the Explore Network and talk about polar bears and what's happening here in the Western Hudson Bay.
So Churchill is sometimes called the polar bear capital of the world, and that's because of the unique situation we find ourselves in here. So we are on the coast of Hudson Bay, in the west part of Hudson Bay. Hudson Bay is a huge body of water, and the waters come down from the Arctic Ocean and then run clockwise in the bay. There's a ton of freshwater input into the bay, and freshwater, of course, freezes a little bit easier than saltwater. And if you look at a map, Churchill is on this coastline that runs west to east, whereas the rest of the coastline runs north to south. So we're on like a shelf here. So as the ice starts forming due to this fresh water and cold water and currents coming down from the north, it starts building up on that shelf. And so we see sea ice here earlier than many other places in the bay. And the polar bears know that. We don't really know how they know that, but it does cause them to kind of migrate through. So we don't necessarily see herds of polar bears, but we do see these large gatherings of bears throughout the fall that are waiting for the sea ice to come back so they can get on it and hunt seals.
Tundra Buggy 1 has always housed the polar bear cam. We started many years ago with National Geographic and had a SD signal that we broadcast out of here. Explore came on, I think, in about 2010 and introduced us to the world of HD and really helped us kind of modernize the system here. Now we've got 6 cams in the Churchill area that cover everything from polar bears to northern lights.
So we can talk about polar bears all day long, but it's only really by showing people polar bears that we really start to cultivate that love of the animal. And it's through that love that people really start to care about the conservation of that animal. So these explore.org polar bear cams have added everything to our outreach project. We're able to talk about polar bears and actually show the animal while we're speaking about them and what they need to survive.
The Explore Network is huge, so we get many more eyeballs than we would have gotten just by ourselves.
Well, you know, polar bears and people have a shared future. So what we're willing to do for polar bears now is really what we're willing to do for our own future grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Polar bears are so special in that they're at the top of this Arctic food chain, and to protect them means protecting the Arctic sea ice habitat. And we really can only do that right now through reducing our greenhouse gas emissions across the planet. That means coming together, making changes for more renewable energies, and all those things is what's going to be good for people too, and ensure that we have a safe future.
And electing people that care is one of the biggest things you can do. You can also make small changes in your life, biking, walking, you know, anything you can do to reduce the amount of greenhouse gases that you're emitting in large numbers will help polar bears ultimately.
And it's not only about the individual, it's not on your shoulders or one person's shoulders, it's about these communities and these states or provinces or larger groups coming together. So folks can look for what's already happening. You can just show your support for more bike lanes or better public transit, or again, these leaders that are actually taking steps for a better future. And it's about working together and having this societal shift into a cleaner future. There's all sorts of ways people can support us depending on whatever someone is able to do. They can go on our website and check out polarbearsinternational.org/get-involved. You can do things at home that involve reducing your carbon footprint. That helps Polar Bears International. You can talk to people about polar bears and your love for this animal and the environment and let people know that this is on your mind. You can also contribute directly if interested. You can adopt a polar bear cub, for example, or you can support our research and education.
If you're kind of on the fence, whether or not you want to maybe get involved, hop onto the Explore site, check out the cams, and learn why we like these animals so much. Mm-hmm.